no memories of him in my life. All I know is that he was incarcerated. Instead of a life with a family, he chose life on the streets. As I grew older, I became angry, insecure, and timid. I didn't have confidence in myself, and saw myself as taking up space. And because of that, I remember wanting to kill myself as early as fifth grade. I was hurt, and I didn't know where to turn. I didn't have a man in my life to talk things through with. My mom, as hard as she tried, could only shield me from the streets. She didn't let me go many places. A friend of mine had been inviting me to ICI, but she would never let me go. But one day, that changed. I remember coming to ICI for the first time. Since I had never been able to play outside much because of the neighborhood I grew up in, playing basketball in an open gym was very freeing. A whistle blew, and we went in to hear a story from the Bible. I still remember hearing about Jesus, and how he was the ultimate superhero. How he came to save everyone, and here I was, knowing men to be mean, bullies, and people who couldn't be trusted. But as I'm sitting there, I hear the story of a man who could be trusted. Not only that, he was willing to give his life to save everyone. His sacrifice broke me, and my walls came down. I knew I needed to trust someone like that. That's the person I needed in my life. That night, after going to my friend's house who invited me to ICI, I gave my life to Christ. Shortly thereafter, men from ICI began investing more and more time into my life, pouring themselves out into me. I joined a Bible study where I learned what it means to be a Christian. As we met at a Burger King, I learned that I didn't make a one-time decision, that it's a lifestyle. As I grew in my faith and matured, I continued to be challenged by men at ICI to take more responsibility. I still remember the question I was asked on the day I signed my application to be hired. We were beginning the Bible study and the leader asked, "Are you satisfied with your relationship with God?" I answered very quickly, "Yes." That day, I learned that I should never be satisfied with my relationship with Christ, that I should pursue him further and deeper. I continued to be challenged to be a man, not a man of the world or a man like my father, but a man of God. I didn't need a father to learn how to be a man, because I had men who were willing to teach me Christ. And only in Christ could I have my anger appeased, my confidence strengthened, and my value be found. Inner City Impact gave me a full ride to Moody Bible Institute, and because of that, I'm 2 classes away from a bachelor's degree. Because of ICI, I met the woman that is now my wife. Ricardo Diaz, known as just Ricky, is who he is because I walked into the doors of ICI and I was introduced to Christ. And multiple people at ICI were there to mentor me and teach me how to be a man following after Christ.